Alila, welcome to the Waypoint Connect studio. It's so great to have you here with us today.
Thanks. I'm feeling really welcome and having lots of fun.
Yeah. Awesome. Great. So what we want to do with our time here is just get people to know you a bit better and talk about our vision and our idea for Upstreet specifically. Our kids areas are crucial to us. They where we really invest. If we had to choose between adults and kids in terms of allocating resources, 80% of those resources would go to the kids because they're that important to us. But before we jump into that, why don't you just share a bit about yourself, who you are and where you're from?
Okay, great. So I am Alida. I'm a speech, language and hearing therapist working in private at the moment. Moved to Port Elizabeth just over a year ago with my husband. He's in the animal feed industry. And yeah, I just have such a passion and just a heart for community. And I am a relator and a developer at heart. And yeah, that's what I like doing. And I'm hoping that this is what I can bring to the table as well when I join the team.
Yeah, awesome. Thanks. And that is, maybe I should clarify in terms of what it is that we're thinking of having you do at Upstreet. So what we're thinking of using your particular skill set for is to step in as a leader for the area, a champion for Upstreet, and really use that as an opportunity to upskill our volunteers that are there so that they've got the soft skills to connect more effectively with the kids, because we know what we do there is built around relationships so that they can become more confident in that. And I know we've got a bunch of awesome volunteers with amazing gifts and talents there. So you've got what you need to build a great team there. So we're really excited about the year that's ahead. Is there anything that you, off the top of your head, that you'd like to share in terms of what you've got in mind for this year?
Yeah, I think, firstly, I just want to say, I think you guys already have such a fantastic base and a really good platform that you already set up here for the kids and for all of the leaders involved. And for me, it's kind of all just about understanding that different kids learn different ways, and it's the same with adults as well. So the minute you step into a role where you work with kids, it's really important to know yourself well enough to also understand how you learn best and how to channel that when you're working with kids, and to also then know I have 5 different types of kids in my group and what I can do to specifically connect with each individual child and to ensure that they have at their disposal just the optimal environment where they can learn in their specific way that suits them best. So if I can dream big, I would really like to have like a small sensory area, because research has shown us that the more we involve different senses of a child, the more the brain lights up and goes into this green zone that we call the learning zone. And by having a sensory environment just to kind of either calm a child down or stimulate a child into a calm and awake and alert state, it really helps them to engage better when learning new material. And it's all just about attachment. So helping, yeah, just equipping the people who work with kids to be able to attach, to create a bit of attachment and to allow a child to understand, I'm safe here, but I'm not only safe, I'm heard, and I'm important, and I have a voice, and what I'm learning is not only temporary, I can carry it up with me when I go back home and influence my environment there.
That's awesome, and I love what you want to install in the environment so that kids pick up on that. And if we look at where we are currently with COVID and social distancing and schools only now starting up, I think there's a lot of there's big room for improvement there currently in terms of what kids are experiencing. Because when we talk about Upstreet, we talk about entry-level primary school kids, and those needs that you've highlighted, that's their needs. If you can fulfill those needs, then you've built that relationship that they need, from which we then show them how to build a relationship with God.
Yeah, exactly.
But you don't have that connection, I don't think it's going to be possible.
Yeah, I don't know where they believe us. And specifically, when you look at the fact that the kids are, you know, they're the future generations who step into the community of the church, And if we can create a space and a platform where they not only learn, but are excited about learning and excited about just being with each other and creating a community there, then we already build the foundation for when they grow up into the church and they become the adults who have their own kids. So we are building a culture here as well. It's not just only about learning. And like you said as well, in that we see Jesus, and in that we see the Word coming to life, which is really important.
Yeah. And also linking in with what you're saying is it helps us as a church, as a faith community, to become relevant.
Definitely.
Because we're not trying to do something in a vacuum, in a bubble somewhere.
Yeah, or isolated. Yeah.
Correct. And in doing that, we're able to impact and change culture.
Yes, definitely. And we are equipping kids not only to be successful in the upstreet or in this church environment. They learn soft skills that they can now apply to their friendships at school. We equip the adults who work with kids to also, you know, understand their own kids better, understand kids outside of the church environment better. And so I love that we're just actually giving everyone a nice toolbox and they can access that whenever they need it.
Yeah,
or wherever they go.
That's awesome. And Andy always makes the point, who wouldn't want to be a Christian? Because it's not just about your relationship with God and salvation, but it helps you to have a better life and be better at life.
Exactly.
And how much better than to start at that age and, like you said, give kids this toolbox that they can access when they need it.
Definitely. Yeah, and also getting the parents more involved as well. Just I'm trying to think of innovative ways of sharing the resources with parents in ways that will really help them, you know, just by giving a child a piece of paper, they jump into the car and it gets lost on the way home.
Yeah.
So we have to think of different ways, sharing resources, helping parents to use those same resources at home as well. And also doing it in a way where kids understand it so well that they can actually sit in the car and teach their parents, this is what we did today. How can we use this at home?
I just love it when my kids come home and they teach me something and like, yeah, I know I'm supposed to do that. So let's start doing that.
Thank you for reminding me.
Yeah. So is that kind of what you got in mind?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And just also getting parents to be curious about their own learning as well. Because like I said, adults are learners too. So we process information differently, and if we can use kids to enrich their parents' experience as well, why not?
Yeah. So I'm really excited for having you on board and taking lead in this environment. So thank you very much for your willingness to impart that and impart in our kids and in our leaders. Thank you very much.
Thank you. I'm really excited. I hope I can do it. It's nice to have a dream.
In closing, the litmus test would be, if you had kids, would you send them to Upstreet?
Oh, definitely, without a doubt. You've been taking off my hands for a while.
And you're investing now so that they can bring their friends as well. Awesome. Great. Belinda, thank you very much. Really appreciate it. And thank you very much for your time.
Yeah, it's only a pleasure. Nice to talk with you.
Great. Thanks.